something that happened to us that we're not cashing in on the abundant life. But watch now. The Bible said these men have crept in unaware. Nobody's seen them because they come in with their turned around collars. They come in with their book titles of bishop and moderators and overseers, apostles and prophets and prophetesses. They're coming in, you understand, unaware. And because people nowadays don't have the Holy Ghost no more, you understand what I'm saying? People are preaching, you understand, a word like I told you today. I said what they're preaching. Now watch this. They'll come in preaching stuff that God ain't told them to preach. So when they're preaching something that God ain't told them, they're preaching according to the flesh. And when you preach according to the flesh, you shall of the flesh reap corruption. God never told us, now you got to listen to me. He, Jesus, God in Christ, never told us to preach prosperity. He never told us that. Now watch, because it seemed like it's working, then it seemed like I'm fighting, I'm a hater. I believe in prosperity. I believe that God wants you to wear the best and have the best and drive the best, live in the best. But God never told us to go after it like that. God never told you to give your money so you can get money. Y'all paying tithes like shooting crap, or paying the lottery or something, or playing a slot machine. I'm gonna pay my tithes by, so I hope that I hit so I can get a new car. You understand? He never told you to give like that. You know I told you to give. He said too much. He said, I want you to give. You understand what I mean? I want you to give. I want you to pay your tithes. I want you to give your offering. Don't give your offering so you can get money. No, Paul said, not as though I'm receiving a gift from you, but fruit that it may abound to your account. Do you understand? You don't need something in the spiritual bank account. What is it if I reap of your corner? I've given you of my spiritual. See, when you give God the natural, when you give God the filthy lucre, the unrighteous mammon, he said, prove me, try me, and see will I not open you the windows of heaven and pour you out a blessing, pour you out a, not them, those of them, they, I'm going to pour you out a blessing that you will not have room enough to receive. There ain't no cars in heaven. Ain't no money in heaven. Y'all don't hear me what I'm saying? Ain't no jewelry stores in heaven. It ain't but one thing in heaven. Somebody said, well, tell me, brother, what's in heaven. I said, I'll tell you what's in heaven. You ought to bow your head and let's pray about it. Our Father, which art where? Y'all better hear me what I'm saying. Well, ain't nothing in heaven but God. God in heaven. So when you give, God say, I'll open the windows of heaven and pour you out me. And when I get here, you won't have enough room to receive me. And when I come, guess what I'm going to do? I'm going to rebuke the devourer for your sake. Do you understand? Paul said, listen, Macedonia, nobody communicated with me concerning giving but you. He said, but guess what? My God shall supply all your need, not needs, according to his riches. Not in a bank, not in a car lot, not in a real estate, but in his riches in glory. In glory by Christ Jesus. You understand what I'm saying? In other words, I'm given to bless you with more anointing. When Solomon them offered up, when Solomon offered up and gave God an offering, offered up all of those sacrifices, God didn't send him no money. You know what God did? God sent a Shekinah glory. God filled the temple with such a glory that the priest could not even minister. They couldn't even enter in. You know what we need in this hour? We need a glory. You understand? The church world teaching us to get filthy lucre and unrighteous mammon. This man never told the watcher. When you start preaching word that's not according to what God say, see, flesh look at it, because it appeals to the flesh. Everybody want to be rich overnight. Everybody want that bling bling. They want to be, you understand what I mean? They want to just be on top of the world. Everybody want to be rich. But listen, God wants you to be rich. He said, beloved, I wish above all things that thou mayest prosper and be in good health, even on an equal keel as your soul doth prosper. God wants you to be blessed, but he never told you to go after it like that. So they preach in prosperity. But what did God in Christ tell us? First of all, he said, first of all, take no thought of what you're going to eat, drink, or what you're going to put on. Don't think about that kind of stuff. You understand what I'm saying? If I will feed the sparrows of the air that don't work, they don't have barn houses, but not one of them will fall to the ground without your heavenly Father. You understand what I mean? Don't take no thought for what you're going to eat, or what you're going to drink, or what you're going to put on. First of all, don't even come to the altar asking for those things. Don't waste your breath on that. Because first of all, listen, I know you're down sitting, you're uprising. I know you're coming in, you're going out. You understand? You know what I know about you? I know your thoughts are far off. Guess what else I know? I know what things you have need of even before you ask me. But don't ask me for that. Don't ask me. Listen, don't you know? Listen, if I was so clothed, the lilies of the field, and Solomon in all of his glory was not arrayed like one of them, how much more will I clothe ye? Oh, ye of little faith, take no thought of what you're going to eat. Now, wait on three occasions. Take no thought what you're going to eat, drink, or what you're going to put on. But rather, this is what I want you to do. Forget about the money. Forget about it. Rather, seek ye first the king that has dominion. Seek the kingdom of God and all of his righteousness. See, with someone, some of y'all, ain't nobody right, anybody doing right no more. So full of the devil, so proud and arrogant. You understand? Mean and nasty and competitive. You look at them right now. Everybody got to have a title. You got to bow down to a bunch of fools. Used to be a time a preacher would come in and preach. Money wasn't an option. He would preach and God would take care of him because he was employed by the people. He was employed by God. God always made a way. Now you got to give me $20,000 before I show up. All that kind of stuff like a contract. Whatever happened to the gospel being preached to the poor? Now we done got on top of the world. You understand what I'm saying? We done got caught up in the filthy lucre. We done got arrogant. You don't even understand. The Bible called them a bunch of dumb dogs, a bunch of greedy dogs. You understand? They're making merchandise out of the people. They don't care nothing about your soul no more. They don't care nothing about reverb now. They don't care nothing about crying out for your soul anymore. They don't care nothing about your well-being. They don't care. All they want is how much money they can give. If they come to a church and it ain't enough people, they say they good message till they get a crowd. You don't understand. How many of you tonight can God send you to one Ethiopian? How many can God send you to one Samaritan woman and you break out revival? You understand what I'm saying? Excuse me. God still got men. God still got women. God, they trust totally in the Lord. Blessed is the man that trusts in the Lord and whose hope the Lord is. You understand? I heard David say, I was young, but now I'm old. I've never seen the righteous forsaken, nor his seed begging bread. You got to understand that God's not mock whatsoever man soweth, that shall he also reap. The Bible said, he that soweth to the flesh shall of the flesh reap corruption. He that soweth to the spirit shall of the spirit reap life everlasting. But I love it when Paul said, hallelujah. When Paul told him, he said, now listen, he said, tell him to be not weary in well doing, for in due season they're going to reap if they faint not. But I love it when he backed up and penned the letter and say, tell them that I'm not forgetful of their labors of love, which they show toward my name and toward the saints. You got to understand, God don't forget. When he appeared under Cornelius, and he said, Cornelius, God sent him an angel and said, Cornelius, he said, listen, your prayers and your alms, your prayers that you prayed for other folk, when you was, your back was up against the wall, you know your greatest prayers is when you up against the wall. You understand? When you feel like you're about to lose your cotton picking mind, you know your greatest prayers is when you're not crying out to God. When you go and pray and you about feel like, God, if you're honest, I'm not even thinking about me. You want a real blessing? You go in prayer and start praying for everybody else. And really, you'll get a master blessing over, a real blessing if you pray for your enemy. I told you to love your enemy, do good to them that hate you, and pray for them that despitefully use you. Why would I tell you to do it? Because you get ready to get a miracle. You understand? But Cornelius, an angel come to him, and he said, I am sent from God. He said, to listen, your prayers and your alms, your prayers and your giving, the stuff that you have done, have come up before God as a memorial. Do you know God don't catch amnesia? God don't got Alzheimer's. He got Alzheimer's. Do you know the Bible said in the book of Malachi, every time you mention the man's name, telling you that there's a book. Y'all don't hear me. When you got cussed out, you could have said M-F-S, but you said Jesus. Every time there was an argument in your house, you could have lashed back, but you said Jesus. Y'all don't hear me what I'm saying. When people lied on you, people talked about you, you understand, you said Jesus. When the devil hit your body, you could have cried, say down 911, but you said Jesus. He said, every time you mention my name, he said, there's a book of remembrance written down. Y'all better listen to me today. Every time time you mention my name, every time you mention my name, every time you mention my name, I write it down in the book. Now watch, they preaching stuff that listen, they preaching stuff that God done told them not to. So what happens, they bringing people out of the realm instead of preaching the word of God and telling people to enter into the kingdom of God and crying out against this flesh and mortifying the deeds of the flesh and preaching to people to put a difference between the clean and the unclean, the holy and the unholy, telling them, you understand, they got to live right, they got to mend their ways, and let them know if they can't get the Holy Ghost, apologize. And see, this message they preaching now, they're coming up with this grace message, they talk about that man preaching, my God, on the message of inclusion. You understand what I mean? And he's wrong. But you preachers done turn right back around and come up with this grace message, because you done took the folk out of the heaven, got them down here with cars and money and fame and a name, and then folk don't have the Holy Ghost no more. So demons that attack them, demons, and they can't fight off homosexuality, they can't fight off lesbianism, they can't fight off, amen, homemonging and adultery, they can't fight off drinking and cussing. So now they get on television and say, God, no, we just a man. Yes, he know you just a man. And why he sent you saving grace. By grace are we saved through faith. It's a gift of God and not of works and not of yourself. Lest any man should boast. He gave me saving grace, but he didn't leave that. He can't leave you with saving grace. Because once he come to you and save you, you understand, the Bible said if you confess your sin, God is faithful and just to forgive you and then cleanse you of all unrighteousness. So I get cleansed of it. You understand? But there's no shedding of blood, there's no remission of sin. But I can't leave you like that. Because when the devil get cast out of a man, he goes into dry places seeking rest. And when he can't find none, he gets seven, go back and get seven more spirits worse than himself. And when they come back, he said, let's go back to my house. He called your body his house. Let's go back to my house. And when he find your house empty, swept, and garnished, your house is empty, swept, and decorated. Y'all don't care what I'm saying. Wait a minute, you done got blood washed. You clean. Just watch the church. Look at the church. It went down in Jesus' name. You understand what I mean? If that's where the preachers stop, they preach salvation. But they don't want to preach commitment because the next one is going to cost your life. You understand? And watch this. So I gave you saving grace. So I can't leave you like that. So what I got to do now, you understand? I'm telling you to repent and be baptized, every one of you, in the name of Jesus Christ for the remission of sin. I told you, repent, for the kingdom of God is at hand. I said, repent, for the kingdom of God is at hand. You understand what I mean? Repent, for the Holy Ghost is at hand. The kingdom of God is not meat and drink, but it's righteousness and peace and joy in the Holy Ghost. You understand what I mean? Because you can't just get empty. You can't just get saving grace. You got to get another grace. You know what it is? The Bible said, the grace of God which bringeth salvation is appeared unto all men. And this time, guess what it's going to do? It ain't going to just save you, but it's going to teach you denying ungodliness and worldly lust, and teach you to live soberly and godly and righteously in this present world. So what it is, I'm going to give you the saving grace, the manifold grace that Peter speak about, the different operations of grace. You understand? Paul said, this grace was given to me to preach the word. There's a saving grace, there's a keeping grace, and then there's a performing grace. I got grace to preach the word today. I got a grace upon me. You understand, to preach the gospel of Jesus Christ. But also, I have to have the keeping grace. You understand what I mean? Jesus saves. But he just don't die on the cross. After he cleans you up, then he jumps inside of you. At that day, you'll know that I'm in the Father in me, and I am in you. And the same Jesus that did no sin, neither was the gal found in his mouth, he jumps inside of you. Paul said, listen, he said, I'm crucified with Christ, nevertheless I live. You know what, why y'all ain't living? Nevertheless I live, not I, I'm not living, it's not I, it's the Christ that liveth within me. And the life that I now live, I live it by the faith of the Son of God. As I live by the Father, even so shall you live by me. Do you understand? You know why folk ain't living? You know why folk can't walk right? You know why the people are teaching you just get saved and do the best you can? Ain't nobody perfect but Jesus. You know why they tell you that? And then God himself then told you in Matthew 5:48, he said, be ye perfect even as your Father which is in heaven is perfect. Why would you give me a commandment that you know I couldn't keep? Y'all don't give me what I'm saying. I know you can keep it. Because guess what? If you'll get saving grace, if you'll get keeping grace, if you'll get the Christ that saved you to live in you. Y'all don't hear me what I'm saying. Don't get him to save you. Get him to live in you. See, that's what's wrong with you. When you live in you, you got to deny yourself. It's sad to come to church and can't come to Christ. It's sad to come to church and can't come to Christ. You know why y'all can't come to Christ? Because it's a price tag. He said, if any man will come after me, let him deny himself and take up his cross and follow me. Imitate me. You understand what I mean? I'm a man of sorrow, acquainted with grief. I'm a man rejected and despised. And it's one thing for people to reject you. It's another thing for people to despise you. But the bad thing, when it pleases God to bruise you. You understand what I mean? When you get smitten of God. Watch this, what I'm saying. You don't want that. They call the master of the house of Beelzebub. You got to eat my flesh. You got to drink my blood. You got to be partake of my divine nature. You understand what I mean? Don't nobody want them to live in them. They just want the salvation. They want the hand of God. I don't want the hand of God. Give me the whole roll. He told Ezekiel to eat the whole roll. Eat the whole thing. What do you mean? Eat it all. The Bible said we grow in knowledge. You understand? We grow in grace and in knowledge. In the knowledge. You understand? We grow in the knowledge of our Lord. Our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. You know what he is to some of y'all? He's just your Savior. He's just your Savior. But he's not your Lord. You know what he said in Jude? He said they crept in unaware. They crept in unaware. Men of old ordained to this condemnation. Ungodly men. You know what they're doing? They turn in the grace of God into lasciviousness. And why it's so hard for me to preach to y'all? That's why it's so hard for me to get y'all to sell out. Because a book across the street around the corner is telling y'all under bondage. Because they preaching liberty. They promising you liberty, but they themselves are bound. He didn't listen. He, the Bible said, he that the Son of Man has set free is free indeed. You know what he freed you from? He freed you to sin. He freed you to eat. He freed you to give an occasion for your pleasure. You know what he come and freed you from? The Bible said the devil sinneth from the beginning. But for this very purpose was the Son of God manifested, that he might destroy the works of the devil. You can't be in him and sin, because ain't no sin in him. You understand what I mean? That my fuck ain't in him no more. You want to live like the devil, do what you want to do, and wonder why you ain't got no Holy Ghost. But they preaching this grace message. The folk them backslid. So they got to come up with a message now. The folk now, homosexuals, alcoholic, changing wives, like changing tennis shoes. You understand what I mean? Ain't no more standard no more. Ain't no difference between the clean and the unclean, the holy and the unholy. Look at the folk today. Look at some of y'all. You don't even come to prayer no more. You don't pray. You know why you don't pray? Because it takes a spirit to pray. He said in the last day, say of God, I will pour out the spirit of grace and supplication upon the house of David, upon the inhabitants of Jerusalem. You know why you can't pray? Because you ain't got the Holy Ghost no more. You know what the Holy Ghost is? It's the spirit of prayer. The Bible said you know not what you ought to pray for as you ought to. But the spirit itself will make intercession. You know why y'all don't want to pray no more? Because you ain't got the Holy Ghost. When you have the Holy Ghost, you will want to pray. When you have the Holy Ghost, you know what the Holy Ghost will lead you to do? It will lead you to pray. Come on, come on, lead me. The Holy Ghost will lead you to pray. It wasn't no interference. You know the Bible said one scripture said it would lead him. And then another scripture said it got behind him and drove him. Come on, drive me. Y'all better hear me what I'm saying. The Bible said he was driven. Y'all better hear me. Years ago, y'all used to have something that would drive y'all to pray. Come on, turn it around. Go down and pray. Y'all had something that would drive you. Y'all had something that drove y'all. You understand what I mean? Y'all had something drove you to pray. You had a hunger in you. You understand what I mean? You get in the bed. It would drag you out of the bed and put you on your knees. Remember that Holy Ghost y'all used to have? Hallelujah, you just convicted. Hallelujah, you would know somebody was at church praying. Hallelujah, that same hour, you would feel so convicted that you would fall on your knees, whether you was on your job. You would find a closet somewhere because you have the spirit of prayer. You remember those days when folk ain't got the Holy Ghost no more? They don't got the power of God, but they preaching money. And you know what the money's doing? It's bringing you out of the heavenly realm and down into the snake zone. How about you boogers can't pay your tithes and can't give your offering, can't be obedient, can't do what God say, because you're in the flesh, and flesh is selfish, flesh is self-preservation. But you know what happened? They're preaching this message, and what they done did, they got folks down here, preachers homemonging, preachers are homosexual, preachers confessing, I'm a homosexual, I'm a lesbian, and that's alright because grace covers it. All you got to do is say you're sorry. All you got to do is say you're sorry. You know what the grace message they preaching is? God got them. God got them. It ain't no accident. God got them preaching this word, this grace. And you know what it does? It makes the church apologize. They say, I'm sorry. That's all y'all doing now is apologizing. You understand? And you apologize. Get on your knees. 2 weeks later, you're doing it again. You know why? Because apology don't move. You know what gets the kingdom? You know what gets the Holy Ghost? John the Baptist said, repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand. Jesus said, repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand. You understand what I'm saying? Jesus said, repent, for the kingdom of God is at hand. You understand what I mean? The kingdom of God is not meat and drink, but it's righteousness and peace and joy in the Holy Ghost. You know why we ain't getting the Holy Ghost? Ain't nobody repenting. Ain't nobody turning around. No, watch, I'm not preaching that message here. But I got to lay the foundation. Ain't nobody getting the Holy Ghost. You know why? Don't nobody repent. To repent means to turn. It means to turn. It means to turn. You understand what I'm saying? It means to turn and go in the opposite direction. It don't just mean, you understand what I mean, to sit up and cry. It does. It'll make you be remorseful. But it don't stop there. If you really repent, repentance is commitment. Repentance is selling out. Repentance is saying, not my will, but thy will. Repentance is denying your self-ambitions, your self-desire. You know what repentance is? It's saying, God, today I'm getting ready to give up the man. Today I'm going to let the woman go. I don't care how many babies we got. I don't care what we got today. You understand? Repentance. And when you go and throw the drugs down, the toilet. Repentance is when you take the phone, hallelujah, just throw it in the tub, or put it in the water. When you take the black book and burn it, y'all don't give me. Repentance is when you call them up and tell them we can't run together no more. Repentance, because see, you can't do it on your own. See, but repentance, it ain't like apologizing. Repentance has got to be in your heart. And see, you got to understand, you could trick me. You can come to the altar apologizing. But God looks on the heart. God see when you really want to make a move. God see when you're tired. God see when you're tired of homemongering. God see when you're tired of getting your heart broken. God see when you're tired of going in and out of jail. God see when you're tired of getting sick and diseased. God see when you're really crying out, I don't want to be perverted. I don't want this spirit in my house. I don't want to bring a curse upon my children. God tonight, God see your heart beat down. He knows that you were shaping in iniquity. He knows in sin that your mother conceived you. He knows ain't no good thing that dwells within you. And when you want to do good, evil is always present. He knows that you're but a vapor that's here today and gone tomorrow. He knows that the spirit is willing, but the flesh is weak. He knows. But guess what else he knows? He knows if I cry out from the depths of my heart and tell God I really want to live right. He knows your heart. And when he finds out you really want to live right and you really repent, guess what he does? He gives you the Holy Ghost. And the Holy Ghost is the keeper. We're kept by the power of God. We're kept by the power of God. We're kept by the power of God. For the kingdom of God is not meat and drink, but is righteousness, peace, and joy in the Holy Ghost. The kingdom of God is not in word, it's in power. You shall receive power. After that, the Holy Ghost has come upon you. I'm kept by the power. So when I find out you really want to live right, and you ain't shucking and jiving, you ain't playing with one foot in the world and one foot in the church, you really want to get a made up mind and a fix apart, I'm getting ready to pour out the Holy Ghost upon you. I'm getting ready to give you a comforter. I'm getting to give you a keeper. I'm getting to give you something. Hallelujah. When it get on you, you get ready to do wrong, it'll pull you back. You're going to say something wrong, it'll check you. Y'all better hear me what I'm saying. Some of you tonight, you used to want the Holy Ghost, and you're playing, but you want to wear sexy clothes. But when you had the Holy Ghost would stop you. It'll make you take that dress and give it to somebody that's real little. Come on, say amen. When you really get the Holy Ghost, it'll help you to live right. It'll help you to walk right. Because guess what? You know what the Holy Ghost is? I would not leave you comfortless. Jesus said, it's expedient that I go away. For if I go not away, Comforter, which is the Holy Ghost. He cannot come. He said, but listen, I'm going, and I will send you back another Comforter, even the Spirit of Truth, whom the world cannot receive, because it seeth him not, neither knoweth him. But you know him, for he dwelleth with you. Wait a minute, you know him, for he dwelleth with you, and shall be in you. I'm sending you back another Comforter. See, that's what make them think it's three gods. All he was saying, in this carnal body, I'm limited to time, space, and transportation. And when I die, it's expedient that I go away. For if I go not away the Comforter, which is the Holy Ghost, he cannot come. But see, when I die, I'm given to take on a glorified body. And you know what that glorified body can do? It can bust itself up in billions of people, pieces, and get in each and every body, and get in each and every one of y'all. It never loses power. You understand what I mean? See, right now, I'm in this body. But when I die, I'm going to become glorified. And I was able to pull my spirit in you, in you, in you. And guess what? You got to listen to me. I got to pour my spirit in you. I'm not sending you nobody else. I'm just giving you another Comforter that ain't going to be in this fleshly body. He said, now listen, I'm going to send you another Comforter whom the world cannot receive, because it seeth him not, neither knoweth him. He said, but you know him, for he dwelleth with you and shall be in you. He said, I will not leave you comfortless, for I will come. I will come. And at that day, you will know that I'm in the Father, and the Father in me, and I am in you. But guess what? If I get in you, guess what it is about me? I'm the same yesterday, today, and forevermore. Guess what? I was a man that did no sin, neither was the gal found in my mouth. When he, the Spirit of Truth, has come, guess what he's going to do? He's going to reprove the world of sin. He's going to make sure you live holy. He's going to come to convict you. He's Jesus. And when he comes, guess what he's going to do? He's going to always do the things that please the Father. He always, listen, he ain't gonna do his own thing. He gonna testify me. You understand what I mean? Look at some of y'all right now. Why you can't pray? Your flesh done got out of hand. Somebody done made you feel comfortable in your flesh, like you can jump on a banana peel and slide into the kingdom of God. But the Bible said men ought to always pray and not fail. He said, listen, pray, pray, watch and pray. You understand? Let you enter into temptation, because the spirit is willing, the flesh is weak. You got to pray. But I can't pray without the Holy Ghost, because I don't even know what to pray for. But if I get to korepe utaya kandalabo koshanderebikia, if I can get the Holy Ghost will make intercession for me with groanings and moanings that which cannot even be uttered. You understand? You know what God's going to do today? God's raising up the spirit of Elijah. God's raising up the spirit of Elijah. Before the coming of the Lord, there's got to be a voice in the wilderness. You look around, how wilder can it get? Look how wild it is in the church. Homosexuals, homemongers, fornicators, liars, rebels. Look at them. A bunch of liars, a bunch of thieves and robbers. It's wild. It's wild. I'm talking about in the church. It's wild. You understand what I mean? Folk are wild. They jump and shout and go in the parking lot and want to fight. Go in the kitchen. Want to throw down. It's wild. You understand? Jump and shout. I got a book at home laying in bed waiting on you. That ain't your husband. Ain't your wife. It's wild. You understand what I mean? Homosexuals on the down low. Lesbians on the down low. It's wild. But before the coming of the Lord, there's got to be the voice of one crying in the wilderness, prepare the way for the coming of the Lord. You know what he's giving to you? We're going to make the rough edges smooth. We're going to make the mountains become hill. We're going to make the crooked way become straight. Y'all better hear me. God's going to raise up the spirit of Elijah that's going to turn the hearts. That's going to turn. That's going to turn. You understand this message going to do? It's going to make y'all turn. It's going to really make you realize I'm messed up here tonight. Somebody go turn. Somebody go turn back to the truth and the living God. There's a dying world out there. And we know somebody to get full of faith and full of the Holy Ghost. There's a dying world. There's we know somebody not to have money, not to have fame, but to be full of the power of God that can break the yoke, that undo the heavy burden, that can break the back. hands of wickedness. Let them lift a yoke up off of your shoulder. Understand, every yoke shall be destroyed because of the anointing. Every yoke shall be destroyed because of the anointing. How God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Ghost. Y'all ain't seen nothing. There's a people getting ready to get filled with the Holy Ghost. There's one filling of many refills. There's some of y'all getting ready to get saved all over again. What else you gonna do? You gonna turn? David said, I can't turn myself. But he said, Lord, turn us again. Turn us again, oh God. Turn me, Lord. Turn me, Lord. I can't help myself. Turn me, Lord. Turn me that I can walk right. Turn me that I can change. Turn me from the hormone. Turn me from the line. Turn me from the perversion. Somebody turn me from beating up my wife. Turn me from cussing out my husband. Turn me from dressing like a whore. Turn me from looking like the world. Turn me from going to the club on Friday, Saturday night, and coming to church on Sunday morning singing I'm going up yonder. Turn me. You know what God not have? He wants somebody, hallelujah, that ain't gonna be in pick a bow. He wants a nonconformist. I sought for a man and I found none. I sought for a woman that said, give me a child lest I die. I sought for a woman that said, I'm not gonna leave the temple till I see the Messiah. I'm sought for a woman that'll say, if I perish, let me perish. I sought for a man that said, oh, that my head were waters and my eyes were found in tears. I weep both day and night for the slain of the daughters of my people. I sought for a man that said, let the priests and the ministers weep between the porches and the altar and cry, God, spare your people. I'm looking for a man that'll cry out and say, Lord, send your anointed. I'm looking for somebody to say, I'm not satisfied and I won't be satisfied until I awaken with no likeness. I don't care about being like nobody. I want to be like Jesus. He said, the works that I do, shall you do also. Y'all don't hear me. Somebody get me to call on his name. Somebody go call on his name. Somebody get me to say, Jesus, take me back, Lord, to the place where I first received you. Jesus, give me back my cry. Jesus, give me back my anointing. Jesus, give me back my glory. Jesus, give me back my hunger. Jesus, give me back my cry. Y'all better call upon him. Somebody today is telling God, I'm not satisfied. I want that Holy Ghost. I want that power. I remember how you used to talk to me. I remember how I used to feel. I remember the glory. I remember the liberty. I remember the joy. I remember the peace. I remember the anointing. God, give it back. God, let me walk like him. God, let me live like him. God, let me be like him. God, please, please.
Wait a minute. Look at him. Look at him. Look at him. Too much. Look at him. They set up here. Look what they're doing. They done put us out of the snake, out of the heavenly realm. He done bless us with all spiritual blessings in heavenly realm, in heavenly places. Look where we are now. We're down here in the snake zone. A bunch of folks squabbling. They got no Holy Ghost. Carnal minded evil. A bunch of murders, a bunch of homos, adulterers and fornicators. It's sad to preach, hallelujah, and be messed up at the same time. It's sad to serve and be messed up at the same time. It's sad to sing Zion songs, hallelujah, but when you finish, you ain't got nothing to comfort you. It's sad to lay hands on other folk when you need laying hands upon you. Like Brother Greg said, I'm tired of being a public success and being a private failure. Some of y'all don't live and leave the church. It'd be a shame. You know what I want? I want to be like Jesus 24/7, 365. He was holy in the church. He was holy on the road. He was holy by the seashore. He was holy in the mountaintop. You know what I want? I want that glory. I want that anointing. I want that power. You look at y'all. They don't even touch you no more. Some of you been home on so long, you done got comfortable with it. And let me tell you something about God. God's making his selection. I said, God's making his selection. You know what he's doing? He's shaking the heaven. He's shaking the earth. And all those things that cannot be shaken. Some of y'all is shaking. Yeah. Folk walking away. Folk leaving the church. Folk turning in the town. Folk saying they ain't preaching no more. Folk ain't coming to church no more. But God's shaking them.
I don't care what it did. It took some of your husbands. It took some of your wives. It took your jobs. It took some of your health. But you got some folk coming to church waving that flag not to give up, but letting the devil know, though the man slay me, yet when I trusted him, y'all set up here today. Let the devil know, all the days of my appointed time, you know what I'm waiting on? I'm waiting on my change. As he told me that these light afflictions are but for a moment, but they're working in me a far and exceeding greater way to go. I'm waiting on my change. What change? Weeping may endure for a night, but joy's coming in the morning. I'm waiting on my change. And if I suffer with it, I'm going to be glorified with it. I'm waiting on my change. That the sufferings of this present time are not worthy to be compared with the glory that's getting ready to be revealed. And you can sit around, give up if you don't. Give up if you don't. God don't lie. God don't lie. Eyes have not seen, ears have not heard, neither entered into the hearts of men the things that God have prepared for them that love him. Hold on, wait, wait. I have fainted unless I believe to see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. Wait, I say, wait upon the Lord, and he'll strengthen thy heart. Wait, and wait upon the Lord. Thou will need the strength of a man of the wings as an eagle, and of the world and not be weary, and of the world cannot fail. Wait, I say, hold on, in patience, possess you the soul. Tell the devil, I'll wait. Don't slay me, I'll wait. I don't care what I got to go through. We can't lie, we can't lie, we can't lie. You understand? If God don't deliver, I know that he's able. I believe God that it shall be, even as it was told me. You know what he told me? He said, my suffering was not in vain. He told me that all things are working together for the good to them that love him. He told me, hold on, I got a reward. I got a reward. I got a reward. Hold fast to that which you have. Let no man take your crown. Don't let him talk out of your blessing. Don't let him talk out of your reward. We right there. We right there. We right there. But wait, I'm getting preached. I'm giving a preach. I've been preaching hard. Down a minute, basically. I've been preaching hard. But what's this? What's this? What's this? I'm going to show you. So here they come in. They're preaching all these damnable words. They're preaching all these heresies and all this stuff. And they're pulling your way. They're pulling your way down just a little. They're pulling your way from the glory of God. And now you set up here full of the devil. So what are they doing? They preach a message to compensate for your sin base. They preach a message to compensate for your sin. So they come up with this message. It's the same message of the message, of the message of inclusion. You hear me what I'm saying? They got the same message of inclusion. In other words, this is grace. All you got to do is apologize. All you got to do is just say you're sorry. And it's going to be all right. Sorry don't get the kingdom. Only thing get the kingdom is the holy, is the repentance. When you really make it up in your mind, see, you can apologize and not be committed. You can say you're sorry. In a few minutes, you can do it again because it wasn't here. But when you repent, you literally say, I'm really mean this. And now I want you to give me something, but I'll never turn back to it again. This is what's going to bring the Holy Ghost. But watch this here. This ain't this where it goes. So they preaching. Watch this. They're preaching and turning the grace of God in the lasciviousness. They're giving you a license to sin. And then they come with another word. They got another teaching that they got. They call it denying. Denying the only Lord God and the only Lord Jesus Christ. They're not only turning grace of God in the lasciviousness and giving people license to sin, but they denying the Lord God. They serving God, the Savior, but they deny the Lord. They deny the Lord, which means master. They deny the Lord. They deny the Lord, which means your guide, your protector, your controller. The Lord, you know what it means? You know what it means, Brother Taylor? It means your owner. It means your owner. See, they don't preach that. They don't preach him as your master, as your Lord. Lord, your controller, your owner. And preach him as savior. He can heal. He can give you blessings. Now preach him as an owner. Tell the truth. Tell him when he led captivity captive. He gave gifts unto me, and he led you from one prisoner to his prisoner. That's why Paul said, I therefore a prisoner of the Lord. Y'all ain't prisoners. You must do whatever you want to do. You watch. What's going to happen in America? You're going to wish to God you had took your orders. You're going to wish to God you had obeyed God. You're going to wish to God you were sold out. You're going to wish to God you had repented. I told you this is the year of exposure. I'm pouring out insanity. I'm pouring out murder. I'm pouring out murder-suicide. I'm pouring out chronic pain. I'm pouring out, you understand, insomnia. I'm pouring out what you boogers won't be able to sleep. I'm pouring out perversion. I'm pouring out lying spirits. You understand what I mean? I'm pouring out perversion. You understand what I mean? God spoke to me and told me that a straight man is going to lay down and go to bed and wake up a homosexual. A straight woman is going to lay down. The Bible said because you failed to retain God in your knowledge. See what y'all doing to me? You see how you do? You come and hear me. You come and hear me. But you will not forbear. You will not take heed. I've become to you like Ezekiel said, as one that have a lovely voice and play well on the instrument. You'll come and hear what I say, but you won't do what I tell you. You understand what I mean? Because you fail to retain God in your knowledge. The Bible don't lie. That's the infallible word of God. He said, because you failed to retain my knowledge and keep my truth. He said, for this cause, I'm going to turn you over to a reprobate mind. I'm going to give you over to vile affection, to do that which is inconvenient, to do that which is unseemly. A man working that with a man, what he should work with a woman. I'm giving to turn them over to homosexuality. I'm giving them over to themselves. You know what God giving to do? You know what God giving to do? God's giving to say to the devil, get on out the way, devil. Me and you gonna get out the way. Y'all niggas think the devil gave you trouble. You think the devil giving you hell. You think the devil giving you hell. You think the devil giving you hell. God's giving to make the devil get back. God's giving to make the devil get back. Down with it. He's going to make the devil get back. You understand what I mean? He's going to make the devil get back. Him and the devil get ready to step back. You know what he's getting ready to do? He ain't going to turn you over to the devil. You know what he's going to do? In Romans 1, it ain't a demon or a devil in that chapter. You know what it is? It's the flesh. I give you over to your mind. I give you over to your will. You understand the devil, but you believe that there's one God. If you do, you do well. The devil believe and he trembled. The devil scared of God, but your flesh, it don't fear God. It call itself fighting God. It call itself being angry with God. It even curse God. Call itself being mad with God. You understand? What I'm going to do is turn you over to you. I'm going to turn you over to you. You know what's in you? Ain't no good thing. I'm giving you over to your own self. Do you know what kind of stuff you can do? You can set up and cut your baby's throat and put it in a trash bag and dump it in a dumpster. You know what it'll make you do? It'll make you take a 6-month-old baby and have sex with it till you bust this wound and make it bleed to death. You know what it'll make you do? It'll make you come home and kill everybody in the house and then blow your brains out. You know what it'll make you do? It'll make you give dope to your little child. You know what it'll make you do? It'll make you jump out of bed from one man to another man, and from one man to another woman, from a woman to another woman, back to a man. You don't understand? I'm giving to turn the world over to themselves. I'm giving to give you over to a reprobate mind. I'm giving to give you over to you. You praying with me. You don't want the Holy Ghost. The Holy Ghost is the only thing that will restrain you. Holy Ghost is the only thing that can help you bring that flesh up under subjection. The Holy Ghost, we mortify the deeds of the flesh by the Spirit. If you ain't got no Holy Ghost, that flesh gonna go crazy. Paul didn't say, Lord, deliver me from the devil. Lord, deliver me from this body of death. Y'all praying with this thing here. You don't understand. All God got to do is make the devil take his hand off, and he take his hand off and let you have your way. You're on your way to hell. You're on your way to through hell. You're on your way to hell. You're on your way to hell. You don't understand what I'm saying. You ain't seen the torment. Your worst enemy is me, myself, and I. It ain't the devil. You worse to yourself than the devil. You understand? Because your flesh ain't got no eternal destiny. It ain't going to heaven. It ain't going to hell. It's going back to the dust. So it'll take your soul. It'll torment your mind. It'll torment you. Look what your flesh doing. Look at your flesh. Your flesh won't even let you come to church. You crying inside. You depressed. You know you need to be in the presence of God. You know you need to pray. Your flesh will let you get on your knees and make you go to sleep, but you can watch TV all night. You can stay on the phone and gossip all night, but your flesh won't let you pray. You can read Jet Magazine. You can read this, but when you read the Bible, two verses, you're going to sleep. It's flesh, and I want you to get close to God. Because if it be, we got to die. Y'all don't understand. You better kill it before it kills you. You better kill it before it kills you. You better bring it to a preacher like me and let me cut on it till the Holy Ghost come out. Let me crucify it till the glory come. Y'all better let me cry out. Say amen. I'll turn you over to yourself. Some of you right now, you messed up yourself. Don't want to pray yourself. Don't want to live holy. You jump out the bed with your husband. But leave. Tell him you're going to Walmart. Make a phone call and go to bed with somebody else. Don't even wash your nasty self off. Come back home. Get in the bed with him. The same way men, dogs. It'll turn you into a dog. You better cry out to God. You better call upon him and tell him, Lord, whatever you do, don't turn me over to a reprobate mind. Don't give me over to the will of the flesh. God, send the Holy Ghost. You praying. You think you can die. God give it a take. His hand. He done gave you a space of grace. He given you a space of grace. He given you a time to repent. I'm stretching my hand. I'm sending Darryl McCoy for the last 2 months crying. Come back to me. Come under me. All you the labor. I'm sending Darryl McCoy crying in the wilderness. Repent. The kingdom. I'm giving to pour out my spirit upon all flesh. Y'all better cry. This is it. This is the end. The door is given to close. The door is given to close.
Is it? The door is getting ready to close. You know what the end means? Something is getting ready to close. When the end, when something comes to an end, it comes to a close. End means coming to a close. Something is getting ready to close. And when it closes, he that is called filthy will be filthy still. He that is called unholy will be unholy still. He that is called unrighteous going to be unrighteous still. Whoever you call, whatever, when that door closes, that's the way you're going to be called. I'm giving you a space. I'm giving you a space. I'm stretching my hand. You playing with me. Y'all playing with me. You think somebody see you. Think ain't nobody see you. All them evil spirits, all that stuff you dealing, playing with it. And pet demons, you giving yourself excuse why they're there. This is why I'm like that. You don't give them demons excuse. You tell God tonight, get this stuff off of me. Get the bitterness off of me. I don't care what your ex done. I don't care what your mama, your daddy. You tell God tonight, get the bitterness. Bitterness got you with another man. Bitterness got you with another woman. And you still don't trust him. You still ain't happy. You still ain't satisfied. You know what you're doing to this flesh? You're accommodating it. You're accommodating it. But this junk, you don't make no provisions for it. You don't feed it. You don't feed the wolf. You remember there's two wolves inside of you fighting. One is evil, mean, and nasty. There's two wolves inside of you fighting. One is evil, mean, and nasty, horrific, sinister. And then there's another one that's good and nice and loving and kind, gentle, considerate. They fighting. But you know which one wins? You know which one wins? The one you feed. The one you feed. You feed them demons. When you look at that porno, you feed them. When you set up them masturbating, you feed them. When you set up on them telephones and you go to talking to people that's contrary to sound doctor, you feed them. You feed them. You feed them. When you talk to a bunch of folk putting their mouth about everybody in the church and nasty because they got an issue, you feed them. You feed them. You feed them. Wherever you got people, you're going to have a mess. It don't make no difference if you leave this church and go to another church. You're going to find mess. People are messy because there's no good thing that dwells in them. So what makes you think you're going to go somewhere? You better learn how to overcome it while you're here. You got to overcome it while you're here. You got to get the Holy Ghost, and the Holy Ghost will help you overcome. The Bible said whatsoever is born of God, whatsoever take on his DNA, overcomes the world. Everything on the outside, you'll get to a point, stuff in your home, stuff on your job, but you'll be able to walk through it. People looking at you like you crazy because it don't even faze you. You know what I'm saying? You're so smooth and cool and calm and collective. Y'all don't hear me what I'm saying. Thinking about the devil. Listen to me. You listen to me. Now watch this here. Listen. So they denied the only Lord God, and they denied our Lord Jesus Christ. The Bible said it's impossible for those that have been once enlightened, that have tasted of the powers of the world to come and partakers of the Holy Ghost, receive that good word, for them to fall away, for them to be restored, seeing that they have crucified to themselves. Now remember, he died and he can't die no more. But they crucified to themselves the Lord Jesus Christ and put him to open shame. They kill him to themselves. And anything dead can't heal you, can't deliver you, can't free you, can't help you. So they denying him. They crucifying him to themselves. So look at this movement. Notice something about the Jewish people that are practicing Judaism, that deny the Christ. Notice what they have. They got law, but no deliverance. No deliverance. Notice Muslims. They got the God of Abraham, but they deny the Christ. They have no deliverance. You don't never see none of them with a deliverance ministry. Notice what some of you black people are doing now with this deep stuff you black people are doing. And y'all finding your identity that you're the chosen black people. Look, no. I'm going to show you how you done went back in the history and you done went back and found out that it ain't no J's. You done went back, watch this. You done went back and found out it ain't no J's, so the devil done told you that Jesus ain't real. So now they don't even call him Jesus, they call him Yahshua and Yahshua. Watch. Look what they're doing. Look at what they're doing. And all of those that done got into this, they have no deliverance. They be on Facebook, YouTube. What do they do now? Debate. Argue. Look at them. There's no healing ministry. There's no deliverance ministry. There's nothing. Because demons don't come out in the name of Jehovah. Demons don't come out in Jehovah Nisi, Jehovah Shalom. Demons don't come out in Yahshua. In my name shall they cast out devils. In my name shall they take up serpents. And if they drink any deadly thing, it shall not hurt them. In my name shall they speak with new tongues. In my name shall they lay hands upon the sick, and the sick shall recover. I done told you about God. This man humbled himself, a man of no reputation, a man that didn't want to have his name heard in the streets. Guess what I did? He humbled himself and became obedient even to the death of the cross. And the Bible said, I highly exalted him. And guess what I did? I gave him a name. I gave him a name of Asia. I gave him a name above every name in the heaven, the earth, and under the earth. I gave him a name above every name in the heaven, the earth, and under the earth. I gave him a name above every name in the heaven, the earth, and under the earth. Y'all better hear me what I'm saying. And I gave him a name. And guess what? That every knee shall bow, that every tongue shall confess that Jesus is the Lord. Look what they're doing. You let them in your house. You understand what I mean? You don't even see what they're doing. They're denying Jesus. You know what your mega preachers don't do? You know the few things you don't hear no more. You don't hardly hear Jesus. You don't hear the cross, and you don't hear hell. You don't hear hell. They denied him. They denied him. They got the Savior, but they ain't got the Lord. You know what the blessings is? Listen, the Lord. The Lord is my shepherd. The Lord is my light. Y'all better hear me. I'm going to lift up my eyes unto the hills. My help coming from the Lord. Y'all don't hear me what I'm saying. The blessing is in the Lord. They ain't scared of him because they don't deal with the Lord. He said, I'm the Lord that kills. I'm the Lord that makes alive. I'm the Lord that killeth. I'm the Lord that maketh alive. I'm the Lord that raise men up. Raise men up. Take men down low, even to the grave. I'm the Lord that raise men up. I'm the Lord that make men rich. I'm the Lord that make men poor. They don't want the Lord. The power's in the Lord. The power's in the Lord. The Lord is my light. Y'all better hear me what I'm saying. Hallelujah. I will bless the Lord at all time. His praises will continue to be in my mouth. You know what they're doing? They're denying the Lord. They don't want you with that name. They don't want you doing it no more. They're coming into church with it. They're telling you, he's Yahshua. He's Yashimi. And
all of that. But when I was laying next to Sister Dorothy, and something come upon me, I couldn't move, couldn't hardly breathe. I was trying to touch her, and it wouldn't let my hands touch her. I was trying to touch her and ask her for help. Baby, help me. But I'm sitting there. This thing was on me, like it was taking my life. But something on the inside, he said, you know not what you pray for as you ought, but the Holy Ghost will make intercession for you. I didn't know what to do, but the Holy Ghost, all of a sudden, something come out of my belly. He that believeth on me, as the scripture have said, out of your belly shall flow rivers of living water. It didn't come out and say, Jehoshua, Jehovah, Jehovah Nasi. You know what came out? They say the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. Guess what came out? Hallelujah. Something said Jesus. Something said Jesus. And when it said Jesus, the thing broke. Guess what? The Holy Ghost know the power. The Holy Ghost know the name. I'm sending you back another comforter whom I will send in my name. It's in the name. At that name, every knee shall bow. At that name, of what they're trying to do. He ain't your Lord. That's why you can't use him. Can't nobody call him Lord. Can't nobody call him Lord. But by the Holy Ghost, if you ain't got the Holy Ghost, you can't call him. You can't call him Lord. If you got the Holy Ghost, he's your Lord. He's your Lord. Y'all better get ready. If you got it tonight, you got power over all the power of the enemy. In that name, use that name. Whatsoever you do, in word and tongue, in deed and truth, do it all in the name of Jesus. There's power in that name. There's healing in that name. There's deliverance in that name. There's joy in that name. Y'all better get ready. I feel like preaching here. I'm trying to tell you, God, give it a raise up somebody. Going back to the name, Jesus, 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 Jesus. The devil is scared of that name. Call him, call him. Whosoever shall call on the name of Jesus shall be delivered. Call him, he'll save you. Call him, he'll heal you. Call him, he'll make a way. Jesus, save my children. Oh, Jesus, oh, Jesus, oh, Jesus, oh, Jesus, oh, Jesus, heal my body. Oh, Jesus, save my soul. Somebody, y'all better get ready. I got to preach here. There's power, deliverance. Y'all better hear me. The devil is scared of that name. Heaven and earth will bow down at that name. Exalted him. That name. Angels back up. Demons run. Y'all better get ready. Jesus, Mary's baby. Jesus, precious Lamb of God. Jesus, the lily of the valley, the bright and the morning star. Lift your hand. Touch somebody. Touch somebody. Tell them, say neighbor. Tell them, say neighbor. Is you ready? Because guess what? Something give it a happen. Tell them, say something is giving it a happen. Tell them, say something is giving it a happen. In Jesus' name. Tell them, say in Jesus' name. I believe a miracle is giving it a happen. In Jesus' name. Tell them, say neighbor. I believe I just got my healing. I believe that my cancer done dried up. The infection is gone. Y'all better hear me. The devil of torment just got out of here. Why? Because somebody know the name. Somebody know the name. When you know the name, you'll make the devil run. When you know the name, y'all better get ready. When you know the name, y'all got your healing. Y'all got your miracle. Y'all got your deliverance. Lift your hand. Shout glory. Shout glory. This is your day. Jesus. 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 Call him. Call take it. Don't let them take it. Don't let them take the name. The power's in the name. Don't let them trick you. It's Jesus. That's what saved you. Jesus. That's what's keeping you. Jesus. That's what's holding you. Jesus. That's what's blessing you. Jesus.
Run over to somebody. Run over to somebody and tell them, say, Nathan, they ain't taking that name. They ain't taking that name. Tell them, say, they ain't taking it. They can't have that name. That's how I got saved. I got delivered. I got my miracle. I got my healing. The devil been trying to fight you for the last 3 years. All in your female track. But God gonna give you a miracle. You didn't come all this way for nothing. The devil didn't find you. I see a scar. But God give me to bring a deliverance to you. When I touch your hand tonight, God give me to touch you from the crown of your head. I see there been times you've been weeping and crying and saying, Lord, the devil trying to make you confused. But guess what? I'm gonna lay my hands on you tonight. And the yoke, I'm talking about the yoke. I'm talking about God gonna refresh you. God gonna give you back your joy. God gonna give you back your peace. You used to call on him. You get better go back to where you first came. Y'all better lift your hand. You know what? God give it to you. God give it to take us back. God give it to let us do our first works over. Some of y'all better get ready. I'm giving to heal you. You remember when you got saved? God didn't just save you. He healed your body, by you. He healed your body. He made you whole. Y'all better call on him. Cry out to him. Tell him tonight, God, tonight, redeem me, revive me, renew me, restore me, redeem me. Somebody today, say, God, give me a makeover. Give me a makeover. Make me over. Make me over. Make me over again. God, make me over. Give me my joy. Give me my dedication. Give me my cry. Give me my holiness. Give me my holiness. Give me my holiness. Give me my holiness. I used to walk holy. I used to dress holy. I used to talk holy. I used to look holy. I used to act holy. Give it back. 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 Y'all better cry. I want it back. My joy. My peace. My anointing. My glory. Give it back. My prayer life. My prayer life. Give it back. My love. My peace. My joy. Give it back. Give it back. My fasting. My fasting. My praying. Give it back. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Somebody need to lift your head back and just say, Jesus, lift your head back. Call on him. Call on him. Whosoever shall call on the name of the Lord shall be delivered. Call him. I dare you to call him. I'll go get your children. Call him. I'll go get your children. Call him. I'll heal your body. Call him. I'll turn your situation all the way around. Call him. I'll fix your marriage. I'll fix your marriage. Call him. Jesus, touch my husband. Jesus, touch my wife. Jesus, touch my son. Jesus, touch my daughter. Jesus, touch my pulse. Jesus, touch my pastor. Jesus, 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 Jesus. Woo! If you ain't got the Holy Ghost, I ain't talking to you. I ain't talking to you. I'm only talking to those that go into that name. You can't take it from me. They're trying to take it. They crept in the church. They got y'all winning it. Talking about you, the black people. But you don't got the name. But it took your identity. Your identity is Jesus. Your identity is Jesus. The Bible said Jesus, in whom the whole family in heaven and earth is named. So when they take your name, you done lost your power. That was a name given to me.
I earned that name through the Holy Ghost. By one Spirit, are we all baptized into one body? I'm Darryl Jesus Christ. I'm Darryl Jesus Christ. You know what made me to Christ? It's the Holy Ghost. Y'all better get ready. Some of y'all got the Holy Ghost. You got the Christ. He was Jesus. He was Jesus of Nazareth. But when he went down to the River Jordan, got baptized and filled with the Holy Ghost, he became Jesus Christ. Guess what? I was there again. But when I went down, got the Holy Ghost, I'm there Christ McCoy. Y'all better hear me. I'm there the anointed one. I'm there the anointed one. I'm there the anointed one. How God anointed Jesus with the Holy Ghost. Y'all don't know it. Come on, please. I got the peace. I'm trying to tell you, when you get the Holy Ghost, you've been anointed. You've been anointed to live right. Anointed to pray right. God put that anointing. God pour it out. God shut it down. Rain, 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 rain on me. 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 Fire! If you want the Holy Ghost, you know what to do. Get up and down. You know what to do. If you want it, you want it. Down. You want it. Come on, brother, get this Holy Ghost. I know you want somebody to lay hands on you. I done preached it. All you do tonight, run up here and accept your miracle. Come on up here giving praise. Come on up here thinking. Some of y'all gonna go to speaking in tongues. Soon as you get here, you know both shot to yet be cool style. Ramba baba kosha be crianzo. Randa le kianda be kosa. I'm not talking about speaking in tongues full of the devil. I'm talking about the real Holy Ghost. The Holy Ghost gonna lead you to stop homemonger. Holy Ghost gonna lead you to stop masturbating. Holy Ghost gonna lead you to stop being a homosexual. Holy Ghost gonna teach you to stop dressing sexy. Pull your dress tail down. Pin up your bosom. Robert Kimmy, Holy Ghost, help me to live right. We want you to deny the name. In the name. In the name. In the name. Give us that name, Lord. Let us walk in that name, Lord. There's power in the name. The authority is in the name. Call on him. Repent. Tell him I want to commit. Tell him I want to commit, Lord. I want to commit my ways. I want to commit to you, Lord. God, tonight, the only Jesus that the world will ever see is the Jesus in us, Lord. They waiting on the manifestation of the sons of God. They waiting on you, woman. How long you gonna hold on? How long you gonna be a whore? They waiting on your family members. How long you gonna be a liar? How long you gonna be a masturbator? How long you gonna download pornography? How long you gonna keep beating your wife? How long you gonna keep stealing? Crowd, how long? Are you gonna keep smoking weed, drinking alcohol, going to the clubs? They waiting on you. The world is waiting on the manifestation of the sons of God. How long you gonna be rebellious to your husband? How long you gonna keep beating on that wife? Call on and tell him. How long, children, are you gonna disobey your parents? Call on and tell him. God, please, please help me, Lord. Please help me, Lord. Jesus, Jesus, you tell me if I call on you, you'll deliver me. Get this home on you. Get the adultery. Get this lust. Get this pride. Get the jealousy. Get the unforgiving. Get this racism. Get this racism. Get this racism. Jesus! I dare you to call his name. Jesus! Jesus! Mama, call him so he can go get your babies. Call him so you go get your grandbabies. Call him, Father. Call him, preacher. Jesus, 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 Jesus. Don't let me deny you, Jesus. Don't let him trick me out your name, Jesus. And never mention your name in church hall at all. Jesus.
Jesus. Somebody need to call on. Somebody just say, Jesus, help me to pray. Jesus, help me to fast. Some of you right now, God, give me an intervene. He said, whatever you asked in my name, I'll do it. It'll be done. Whatever you asked in my name, whatever you asked in my name, whatever you asked according to my will, Jesus, give me the Holy Ghost. Jesus, give me the Holy Ghost. You said it's your Father's good pleasure to give me the kingdom. Give me the Holy Ghost. God, you got to give some people the Holy Ghost. They're going to die if you don't know. God, there's some people give me to perish if you don't give them the Holy Ghost. God, there's some people give me to lose their marriage if you don't give them the Holy Ghost. God, there's some people give me to go back in the world and they get me to get to the point of no return, Jesus. There's some folk going to go out and blaspheme and they're going to never be able to get back, Jesus. Don't let them go. Give them the Holy Ghost in Jesus' name. Jesus! Jesus! Get your healing. Get your healing. Get your healing, woman. Get your healing. Tell him I want to commit. Tell him I want to commit to your name, Jesus. Tell him I want to commit. I want to repent. God, I want you to come in. I want you to live your life. I want you to live your life. If you don't get the Holy Ghost, your marriage ain't going to last long. The devil already got you slipping. You better cry out to God. You better cry out to God. Some of you get ready to blaspheme. You're going to cry out to God. Some of you get ready to walk away. Some of you done walked away, but some of you going to walk away for the last time. Tell him I can't afford it. Tell him I can't afford to go nowhere this time. Jesus, please hold me. Hold me, Jesus. Keep me, Jesus. Protect us, Jesus. Deliver us, Jesus. From the inside out, deliver me. From the inside out, deliver me, Jesus. From the inside out, live in me, live on me, live through me. Oh God, put that real cry back in them, Lord. Put that holiness back in their soul, God. God, you give an anointing some of these men, some of these women, God. Are they folk getting jealous because of the anointing, God? These are people that's seeking after you, Lord. These are people that ain't playing, Lord. These are people that want to go to the next level, Lord. These are people that want to go to another realm. God, they know how to go out and come back home and humble themselves as a servant, Lord. God, you give me to highly exalt their name, Jesus. You give me to highly exalt them, Lord. You give me to highly exalt them, Jesus. You said if we'll humble yourself under the mighty hand of God, that you would exalt us in due time, Jesus. God, there's somebody humbling themselves in your name, Jesus. God, you said there's a people that you're going to raise up in the last day, Jesus. Come on, call upon him just for a minute. Oh, God, listen to the cries of the people. Listen to the one calling your name, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Jesus for my healing. Jesus for my healing. Jesus for my deliverance. Jesus for the peace in my mind. Jesus. Jesus for my dedication. Jesus for that fast that I want to go on. Jesus. Jesus for my prayer life. Jesus. Jesus to be kept by your power. Jesus. Jesus for your love and your commitment. Jesus. Call upon him, children. Call upon him, children. Please, some of you better cry. Cry out while the door's open. The door's giving to close. That's why it's getting harder to pray. That's why it's getting harder to fast. That's why it's getting harder to come to church. The door's closing. Don't let the door close on you. Enter in. oh God.
Come on, just for a few minutes. Come on, saints, come on. Don't leave here empty. Don't leave here. Don't leave here empty. Don't leave here empty. Leave here with the name. Leave here with the name. Leave here with the name. Leave here calling on that name. Call that name in the midnight hour. Call him while you're driving down the road. Call him when you wake up. Call him when you get up to use the bathroom. Call him when you get ready to go to work. Call him when you get ready to take a shower. Call him while you're ironing them clothes. Call him while you're cooking up food. Jesus, Jesus. There's a book that's going to be wrote down every time you mention his name. Jesus! Jesus, help your people, Lord. Help your people, Jesus. Jesus, let us not be ashamed. Let not our enemy triumph over us, Jesus. Jesus, send your protection. You said to be more than conquerors through thy name. He said, "Great is he that is innocent, and he that's in the world." Jesus. Jesus, let that woman go, Jesus. Jesus, get the verse off of her, Jesus. Get the spirit off that man, Jesus. Get that demon that's about to destroy him, Jesus. Get that demon about to take him under, Lord, Jesus. Jesus, before it's too late, save us, Jesus. Before it's too late, Jesus, save us. Before it's too late, Jesus, save us. Come on and call upon him. Father in heaven, oh Lord, I minister this word tonight, Lord. God, the devil coming to take that name to make us deny you. He wants us to deny you. That's why they don't even mention your name, because to mention your name is to mention your life. And your life is a life that's sin-free. Your life is a life of holiness. Your life is a life that you do always the things that please the Father. Your life is a life that you do always the things that please the Father. Oh, God. Father, we thank you. Oh, Jesus. Oh, Jesus. Oh, Jesus. Oh, Jesus. Oh, Jesus. Put that O on and watch it. Oh, Jesus. 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 Oh, Jesus, oh, Jesus, oh, Jesus. Oh, Jesus, oh, Jesus. Oh, Jesus, put the oil on there, watch what it does. Oh, Jesus. Oh, Jesus, oh, Jesus, oh, Jesus, oh, Jesus. I need you, Jesus. Oh, Jesus. I need you, Jesus. Oh, Jesus. I need you, Jesus. Please touch him, Jesus. Please, before it's too late, please touch this church. Please, Jesus. Please, Jesus, touch this church, Jesus. Please, Jesus. I want you to stand on your feet all over this building with your head bowed. Your eyes closed. Don't look around. Put your head bowed. Don't grab nobody by the hand. Just bow your head. And I want you to say something personal to him. What you need him to do right now. You tell him what you need him to do right now. God, I need you to move for me in my home. I need you to touch my body, Jesus. I need you to move for me. God, I need you to send me help, Lord. I need help, Jesus. I need help. I can't do this by myself, Jesus. Help me, Jesus. Help me. Help me, Jesus. Help me, Jesus. Help me. Oh, God, I need strength, Jesus. I need your strength, Jesus. I just need your strength, Jesus. I need more of you, Lord. I need more of your anointing, Jesus. I need more of your glory, Jesus. I need you, Jesus. I need you, Jesus. Oh, God in heaven. Lord, I thank you, Lord. I thank you, Lord. I thank you, Lord. God, please put a stir in them, Lord. Put a cry back in them, Lord. Let them go home seeking you, Lord, praying, God, give me a chosen fast. Give me a chosen fast, Jesus. Give me a chosen fast, please, Jesus. Please give me a chosen fast, Lord. Let me break this flesh again, Jesus. Let me do it, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. You told me whatever I asked in your name, Lord, if it's according to your will, you told me you would do it for me. Give me a chosen fast, Lord. Let the spirit of holiness be upon us, Jesus. Let it be upon us, Jesus. Take the sin out of my life, Jesus. Please, Jesus. Take disobedience, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Oh, God, bless you in the name of Jesus. Father God in heaven, Lord, we just thank you today, Lord. Lord, there's a deliverance come up in this place, Lord. Folk waiting on somebody to lay hands, Lord. They don't know you laid hands in this place. God, you sent in a glory. You sent an anointing. You sent a power. Come on, reach up to him, strings. Come on, reach up to him. Just call his name while you're standing. Just by yourself, personal, this personal, this personal. Some of you getting a breakthrough. Some of you getting a breakthrough. Some of you just feeling pressed. He's wrapping his arms around you right now, loving you. Giving some of you strength. He's giving some of you strength. Some of you just stand in the need. It ain't a matter of making the decision. It ain't a matter of having a made up mind. Some of y'all's minds made up. Some of your hearts are already fixed. Some of you just say, Lord, just give me strength, Jesus. Just strengthen me, Jesus. 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 Strengthen my family, Jesus. Strengthen my sons, my daughters. Strengthen my grandbabies, Jesus. Strengthen the saints, Lord. Strengthen us, Jesus. Strengthen my preachers, Lord. Strengthen all my sons and daughters in the gospel, Jesus. Strengthen us, Lord. Strengthen us, Jesus. Lord, you tell me only the strong will survive, Jesus. Strengthen us, Jesus. You said to be strong in the Lord. You're only going to be strong in the Lord and the Master and the owner, Jesus. Strengthen me, Jesus. Oh God, I thank you today. Appreciate you for your goodness. I want you on your way back to touch somebody on their shoulder and say, Lord, strengthen us again. Just touch them on the shoulder and say, Lord, strengthen us, Jesus. And put your hand on somebody's shoulder and say, Lord, strengthen us, Jesus. Strengthen them, Jesus. Put your hand on their shoulder. That's something about putting their hand on their shoulder. Go touch somebody. Just put your hand on their shoulder. Lord, strengthen them, Jesus. Put your hand on their shoulder. Touch of Jesus. Touch of Jesus. Touch. God, she is tired, Lord. She's tired, Lord. They don't know Jesus. It's getting to the wire, Lord. She don't want to lose everything. Jesus, please. Please, Jesus, please, Jesus. Touch her, Jesus. Touch her, Jesus. Touch her, Jesus. Touch her, Jesus. Help him, Jesus. Touch somebody on the shoulder. Just get up, go touch somebody on the shoulder and say, Lord, help us. Strengthen us. Just get up out your seat and go touch somebody on the shoulder. Y'all playing with this thing. You think this is just something I'm doing? Go touch somebody on the shoulder and say, Lord, strengthen us. Strengthen us in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Just go touch somebody. Go touch somebody. Go touch somebody. Just touch somebody. Just touch somebody. All over this building. Strengthen us, Jesus. Strengthen us. 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 Strengthen them. Strengthen them in Jesus' name. Thank you, Jesus. I want you to stand up. Come in, Jesus. Stand right here. Take your hand. Put it right there. He's going to give you a miracle. Doctor call him sis, but ain't number two. God going to give you a miracle. God gonna give you a miracle. If it ain't been one thing, it's been another. All your life. All your life. You know it hurts when you have to buy love. You know when you have to just, you know, do, you know, just can't be accepted, you know, and let you do some extra stuff. You know, that hurts. That hurts. That hurts. That hurts. And anything go down, they always want to blame you. You know what I mean? That hurts. I know what it feels like. But God gonna give you a miracle. You didn't drive all these miles for nothing. It's your day. It's your day. I'm gonna tap you three times. He gonna lift that spirit. It's a spirit come upon you. See how you cry? Sometime it'll wait till he leave and you'll break out and go to cry. Sometimes you try not to let him know because you don't want to put no extra pressure upon him, but you'll break out and go to crying as a spirit of depression comes upon you. But God gonna give you healing. God gonna give you healing. You'll never be the same. You'll never be the same. Peace. 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 I don't know what this is about children, but God gonna work this stuff out. I don't know what this is about some children. God gonna work this stuff out. Thank you, Jesus. You know how folk fight something? You know how they fight, you know what I'm saying? They just, folk want you to do what they want you to do. Do you understand what I'm saying? God gonna work this stuff out. Lift your hands. Lift your hands. You ain't saying nothing. It's gonna get better. It's going to get better. It's going to get better. Something getting ready to break out in this country. I've been trying to warn you. I've been trying to tell you to get in God. But I know it's just like, you know, Bubba McCoy, he just playing. And there he go with that junk again. When I told y'all I saw that water 2 weeks later hit Baton Rouge. When I told them folk up in Jacksonville I saw all that water coming up in there. God left three hurricanes. I told him yesterday. I said, God ain't playing with y'all. He let two hurricanes come at the same time and go up like that. Then he let another one come and just graze. Go along the beach, tow the beach up. That thing went all up in Carolina and then folks are still messed up. Come straight to Jacksonville. Few trees, few powerhouses. I saw water. I screamed yesterday. I screamed so loud. I saw water. I screamed yesterday. I saw water. I told Jacksonville if I could find 100. Know if I can find 75. Know if I can find 50. Know if I can find 25. Know if I can find 10. That are seeking after me. I'll turn the judgment. I'll turn it. There were men that looked at the storm and said, peace, be still. There were men that spoke to the sun. And the sun stood still. And the moon stood still in the valley of Ajalon for a whole entire day from the voice of a man. Man spoke and shut the heavens up. Spoke again and the heavens opened. You don't believe this stuff. I know it's all right. You go in these churches, fool around. Ain't got no power because they don't mention Jesus. We get ready to go back. And that name got so much life. And those of you right now just feel like something just like a refreshment physically and spiritually. Stand on your feet if you just felt like this word did something. You watch. If I can get you to just get mono and quit seeking after second opinions. Because second opinion is going to give you a reasonable doubt. Let it go. She is a prayer boy. Let it go. It's in the puff of it. In the puff of it. Get him off of. Free him.